Thanks so much, Axel Toss. You can tell it's a home crowd, Carpet.
Yeah, goosebumps again. That's another one. That's another one for the books.
We'll just keep on counting here. We've got The Leftovers, the classic underdog story, came from nothing and now a favorite among the fans. And on the other side, the clear secondary team. You heard Gibbs saying it. They're second in all the stats, and we've seen Turtle living in NRG's shadow for so long. Can he break through here with his rogue squad?
And I think it's easy to forget, Turtle's been here every single land. He is every an experienced player. And look who he's with, Matt and Sizz. We've talked about him plenty of times on this broadcast. They've been playing together pretty much since the game came out. Mm. When everyone had about 1,000 hours underneath their belt, they had 1,000 hours just together.
Yeah.
So I think that alone is going to give them so much experience in this game.
And I love that Gibbs tried to help the Leftovers out by saying, okay, I'm going to pick against you. And then the Leftovers turned out to be the favorite of the entire rest of the desk. So the Leftovers having to play against being the favorites. They love to play from behind. Let's see if they can do it here against Rogue. We will see the Leftovers in the orange, Rogue in the blue. And after winning kickoff, we see Sizz able to push this one back out to midfield. The Leftovers look to keep the ball in the blue. It'll be Matt on the wall now, alone. Sizz out in the mid, looking for the pass. Gets it over the top of Sizz, actually, and that'll leave it with the Leftovers in the midfield. Farrah now to the corner. Sizz and Turtle will rotate. Game number one here on DFH. Best of five. Winner continues on in the upper bracket. The loser dropping to the lower bracket. And well, it is the underdogs versus the runners-up. Who will be able to take it here in round number one?
You'll almost always see first round jitters, and it seems that Leftovers want to make sure that they are the first ones to sink the first goal, and they have had possession this entire time. But with the hype Rogue came onto the field with, I wouldn't let them.
Whoa, Matt's going to be able to get that one through all the defense. That's Rogue on the board.
And that's going to be enough to get them pretty stoked. This pass from Sizz out to Matt. There's the duo we know so well. Placed beautifully to the top right corner, Matt and Sizz.
Precise coordination, putting Rogue up here. Team USA in the lead by one. Now Matt, seeming to extend the lead here. It's just him versus Snatsky. Over the top, does he finish it? No, it's wide. And the Leftovers will be able to dodge a bullet, see if they can move this out of their own half. Farrah and Snatsky moving out together. Farrah in support will be in the air to bounce this one around the corner. Bounces off of Matt instead, but still heading towards the net. Sizz gets the save. Matt with the redirect and Sizz with the follow-up.
I think everyone underestimates Matt was second runner, or he was, I guess, the runner-up for MVP in North America. Woo. He's doing well, but there it is, a shot from Leftovers. They want to make sure they tie this up.
Save from Sizz. Now the pass, Matt to Turtle. Can they finish it off? He gets a save. Clears it out for the time being. He'll follow it up himself. Here comes the transition, but wide hits there. Give the ball back to Rogue. Now Turtle down to Sizz. Takes the shot. Blocked by Snatsky. Matt in loses the 50-50. Now Leftovers with an opportunity. Sicky will put this onto the backboard. Tries to double tap it himself, but misses. And now Farrah in a sticky situation. A lot of space given there by Rogue, and Farrah will be able to turn this one around. Can he finish it off? No. Turtle will slam the door.
They have to be careful, but both teams have done a good job of not overcommitting. We haven't seen many double commits yet so far this game. They're playing patient. It's a matter of how much space they give to their opponents.
Touch from Turtle. Off of Sicky, bounces down into the orange box, but Snatsky picks it up. Neutral 50-50 will drop near the midfield boost, and Farrah will miss after the touch from Turtle. But Sicky in the air first. Gets the ball deep into the blue. Savior medal for Sizz here early in the series. 2:41 left to go, and it's still Rogue with the one-goal lead. Turtle in the corner gets it past Farrah and able to get it past Snatsky as well, but the ball so high, no shot materializes. Here comes Matt and Sizz, though, again. The shot just barely wide of the Leftovers' goal. Farrah will look to clear.
I'm surprised to see Leftovers standing so stagnant. I think they must be starving for boost right now. Just staying on the ground with these shots coming right at him.
And Farrah saw it clear towards the net. Matt will easily block, but it buys the space to get out and get that boost you're talking about. Touch will drop straight back down. Turtle to Sizz, looking for the redirect. Snatsky off the hood, back into blue corner. Looking to tie the game back up. Farrah on the backboard, uncontested right now, but no follow-up will mean Matt and Turtle can clear this one back, transition back onto offense. And here's the shot from Turtle, shut down by Sicky, and Snatsky and Sizz in a 1v1. Sizz will just let it bounce off his hood, and Farrah will go up in the air. Snatsky waiting in the back, on the backboard rather, looking for an opportunity. 1:44 left to go. Rogue still just holding on to this one-goal lead, trying to make it two.
And watch Rogue seek each other out every time they have possession. They're looking for a teammate. They don't want to waste any opportunities. Sizz now off the backboard. Will Turtle get there?
Oh, it went in. The pass from Sizz setting up Turtle. It's a two-goal game.
Turtle able to secure the goal over defender. Sizz Well placed, getting underneath the ball to keep the height as opposed, and Turtle putting it just under the crossbar, keeping his accuracy in check.
These passes from the Rogue Squad have them up by two in game number one. The Leftover still looking for that first goal on the land stage. Turtle gets a pass, just Snasky in the back right now. He'll take a shot, but Snasky able to block it away at the last moment. Matt will keep the pressure on. The Fair gets the high clear. And Snasky move up in front of him, hoping for a cherry-picking opportunity, but Turtle there. Right now, it seems that most of the 50-50 is going in favor of Rogue. Easy cleanup right in the back, 3-0 for the Americans.
All because of a demolition on Zicky. You talk about how he might be the best latent player in the world, but if he's not there to make the save, it's still going to go in now. Three goals up, it's looking real good, starting off this series for Rogue.
Yeah, and right now the Leftovers needing to collect themselves and think about what they're doing. What can they change up to get more opportunities to score? Right now, the opportunities, the shots on net have not been that plentiful for the Europeans here, and they need to find a way to get the ball into the back of the net right now. They're playing so much defense, and I believe a big part of that is losing out of 50-50s, especially in the air.
They seem to be playing just a bit slower, Rogue outpacing them, getting the contest they need, but this is actually going to be a risky touch. Sizz couldn't get control, but again, there, no one from Leftovers contest that.
No pressure, no follow-up. With the final minute counting down here, Rogue sitting very pretty on their three-goal lead. This will probably most likely secure up game number one, and we'll go to game number two, with the Leftovers needing to tie it back up. Sicky will loft this one. Snasky to play it away from the corner. Matt keeps the pressure on, and you see Rogue just continuing to do what they've done all game long. Just keep the pressure on. If they can just keep on popping it up here, like volleyball. Just keep it away from the Leftovers. Not allow them to have any ball control. Matt will take another shot. That'll go in. Easy goal there to finish it off. Just kind of a nail in the coffin of game number one. 9 seconds left. You're down by four. Leftovers not going to be able to bounce back, but they will need to start again. Recollecting, Zicky, thinking about what they're doing.
Zicky waiting on that backboard. But first game of his RLCS LAN experience, and Matt gets a hat trick.
Oh, my goodness.
Got to be a good feeling for him. This is his first showing here, but the pressure does not seem to be hindering him in the slightest. Quite a lot of skill and showcasing coming from all of the Rogue Squad right now. 4-0 in the first game. We know Leftovers do well after they lose. Will they be able to keep that up even on a stage this large?
Game number one going to go to Rogue. Quickly taking that one 4-0 over the Leftovers. Looked a bit disheveled, not able to put anything together there. You could see an assist, the playmaker coming out from Sizz there. Mm-hmm. That's Rogue leads the league, I believe, in playmaker medals. They're the only team that has had one per player in season three.
They were tied in saves, actually, corresponding. Both teams had 5 saves. But at the same time, that really shows which team had more threat on their shots. Mm. And that beautiful bump, or sorry, the demo from Matt right on Sicky, their last man, there's nothing they could do about it. Gave him a wide open shot. Yep. They're finding their opportunities. They're not overcommitting. And it seems that Leftovers playing a little too reactionary is what it seems.
Yeah, and they're, I think we talked about in the middle the losing a lot of 50-50s, not having much ball control. You can see in their personal score, not a single player breaking over 200 personal points, where all the players, the lowest player on Rogue was Turtle with 255, Matt with 490. So much more ball control on the side of Rogue. They're outpacing Leftovers right now. They need to be able to pick up the game pace if they're going to take it to Rogue.
Yeah, in mid-game it was so obvious to see that Rogue, they were seeking each other out with every single touch. They were always, it seemed to be just one step ahead. They know when a clear came their way, what do they need to do? One person was going to get a touch out, but somebody was already cheating up ahead, trying to make sure that they were ready for a pass instead of just letting those balls go out, where it seems that Leftovers maybe struggled a bit in that, and they were maybe always one step behind trying to think of what was going on.
So we'll see if in game number two, we'll move on to Manfield, and we'll see the Leftovers. What do they change? What new do they bring to the table? Because Rogue had their number there in game number one. First kickoff going on to the orange side, but Farah alone will be able to ultimately win it out. We'll take a slow approach. Interrupted, and the ball will bounce high, sticking out in the air. First one to make it. Keep the ball deep in the blue, but cleared on a pinch out towards Sizz. He'll follow this up, look for the quick transition towards the net. The shot will go wide, and Snasky will block it anyway out to Matt. That touch actually keeps the offensive going here for Rogue. And Turtle's pinch will send this one high to Farah. They'll put it back into the blue. Both teams with an opportunity to score, but still scoreless here in game number one very early on.
And there it is. Leftovers has to be careful where they're placing this ball, and are these touches worthwhile? Some have just been kind of giving up possession and giving up control. A Rogue, we can see it looking for each other almost with a redirect right in front of net.
Turtle to put it in, past the defender. Game two picks up right where game one left off, and Rogue's in the lead.
Watching that from Siki's perspective, he was just waiting for that shot to come his way. He took his time, knowing it would be an easy save, but Turtle coming from off screen to push it towards the right-hand side of the net, giving them the lead yet again.
And just as you said, Siki planning on saving that one, which would be a kind of cookie-cutter save, if there wasn't for the massive amount of pressure that Rogue is able to put on them, the pace that they are playing at, Leftovers is not able to match at this moment. They need to be able to change it up if they want to make a series out of this. Snasky out towards Farah. Siki will try to shoot it through. But Sizz now in the corner, just keeping this ball in the blue corner. Averaging probably 10 kilometers per hour right now. Very, very slow speed over here. They'll finally get it out. And Turtle looks to set it up to the midfield. Matt rotates wide. Gets a pass, Farah, but Snasky in support. Up towards his teammate, the cherry pick. The shot towards the net, blocked away by the Rogue defenders.
Oh.
And then the demo will send Snasky back to the back lines, open up a bit of space for Rogue to move out.
The demos that Rogue have been putting onto the Leftovers is absolutely crippling any opportunities that they're having on both offense and defense. And it just feels like Leftovers are playing a little bit slow.
Oh, Sizz with a shot towards the net, blocked by Snasky, but still in a dangerous position. Turtle's there, takes a follow-up, but Siki's there, able to block it away. The defense holds on. It's still just a one-goal game, but the pressure from Rogue continues to come here.
They are on fire right now. I cannot believe they were able to get the angles and the shots they just procured from that play.
Siki up towards Snasky. Farah sitting in midfield, looking for the shot opportunity. Here he goes. The shot will go. Oh, and it bounces down. Barely makes it in, but we got a tie game.
On a counter-attack play with only two shots on goal, one of them being this one going in. Farah goes for the bounce shot. Sizz tried to read it, thinking he'd keep it on the ground, but well played by him, waiting for that bounce and pushing it back in so it bounces up towards the crossbar.
And the first goal for the Leftovers of the World Championships for Season 3 going to none other than the rookie, Farah. Made waves in week number one with a reverse sweep of flip side. Here they're going to look. And it's easy to look at that first game and be like, oh, wow, Rogue just so much better than Leftovers. This is the team that made their name on the reverse sweeps. You can never count these guys out until the ball touches the ground at the end of the last game. Siki will look. See if they can get a lead now. They've tied up the series right here at halftime, game two. Siki towards the backboard, Snasky waiting. He'll take the shot, the block on the wall, opening up the goal, and that's the Leftovers with the lead.
Matt tried to get a bit too antsy for this. Turtle was cheating up. Matt tried to come up on defense, but he left it wide open, forcing himself to make a nearly impossible save off that backboard. And the moment the Leftovers saw their opportunity, they took it. They are now 2-3 shots.
That is 2 goals the Leftovers have scored on a failed spider defense, a whiffed spider defense on the backboard, but they're gonna try and tie it back up here. It'll bounce around and in. The pinball goes through, and we got a tie game.
Tied up, and again, off of kickoff, Snasky, instead of coming from net, tried to push that from the side, didn't get the touch, and he was last man. If he didn't get that, that was it for him. Seeking it from the back, Matt noticed it from midfield and came to secure the goal.
2:13 left to go, and it's all tied up once more in game two. These teams playing evenly. And Matt, a long shot downfield. Siki to the side. Matt will off this one. Turtle looking to pass. Miss. Sizz was not really prepared for what was offered to him ball-wise and ended up in the corner, but he comes back to make the clear to the side. Maybe Turtle moving out first in the one position for Rogue. Allows Farah to win the first touch. That's pass three. It'll just go in off the touch from Snasky. They just put it around him, slalom through all the Rogue players, and Leftovers as the lead.
Turtle couldn't contest that. Not a lot of boost. And Sizz off the back wall. A bit of a risky play. May have wanted to wait for that to fall closer to the ground, maybe closer to the wall, or aim for the 50-50. But since he got a weak touch, it left the last defender in net. Couldn't get the save.
Matt will off this one high as they look to tie the game back up. After having a dominant win in game number one and the lead early on in game two, they are now down by one with 1:30 left to go. Here's an opportunity for Matt taking the shot. Siki will place it high. Farah rotates around to Snasky on the wall with the clear. Farah will watch this one as it touches all the way down. Bounces towards the goal. Turtle to Sizz. The aerial pass, the air dribble. Can he do it? No. Snasky says no. None of your shenanigans. Take that somewhere else. This is my game, and he'll be able to get the clear finally. 106, final minute approaching, is still the Leftovers with the one goal lead.
Rogues seem to be second guessing themselves a little bit more this game than last game, but we do see some great passing plays from them, like Is it enough? Will they score in the next 50 seconds?
The offense from Rogue has still been very solid. As you see Sizz here going to be able to pass that one towards Turtle. He wasn't ready for it just yet, but they'll keep it on it. But Matt missing that touch on the side, kind of indicative of the goals that have been scored. Sicky will punish once more and continue it. Defensive mistakes continuing to be punished here by the Leftovers.
Yeah, all it really takes is one tiny whiff, especially at this caliber of Rocket League. One mistake in your rotations and your entire team is off. A massive hole for any of these players. I mean, they can score on the tiniest of opportunities, but the moment a player is even just half a second lagging behind, it's going to be an easy shot for them, and Leftovers have been seeking them out.
As three goals now scored on defensive lapses from the Leftovers, and that would be the difference. That's the difference in the lead at this point. Rogue, they're going to be able to get one more in here. 30 seconds left, now up by three. Leftovers come back, making the statement they'll be able to tie up the series, Carpet.
At this point, I feel like Rogue probably knows that they don't have this game in the bag. Most likely, it seems that Leftovers played a little bit more patiently, which in the first game I think hindered them a bit. They were leaving Rogue too much space, allowing them to have all the passing plays they wanted, and eventually a lot of those shots went in. But this time patience paid off because it was up to Rogue to make the mistakes, and they've made a good handful.
Snasky's rocking that RLCS decal you can get just by watching the stream. It's got the big old RLCS shield right on the hood. It's a gorgeous car there. Matt will get a goal in here. Kind of a consolation goal. 16 seconds left. I would be amazed if they tie this back up. But at this point, I believe the Leftovers have game two.
That's actually a really nice play, though. Yep. Turtle trying to make sure he got the read on that touch towards the corner. Instead of placing himself towards the midfield, which most people predict the clear to go, he knew it would get pushed towards the corner. Got the read, pushed it to the middle, but with 15 seconds left, can they score two more?
Farrah just being a wall there in the midfield. Turtle with the setup. This is an opportunity. He'll be able to, so close, cannot get it through. That would have lit the fires for the next kickoff, for the opportunity to tie it up here. But as the game hits the 0 second marker, that will be the end of it. And the Leftovers will tie up the series. They take game two.
Leftovers able to make sure they capitalize on every mistake they see, which is probably something Rogue just needs to clean up. They had the lead, and all they had to do was stay patient. Actually, no, did they? That game, I don't know if they did. Now I'm drawing a huge blank.
I'm just looking at the fact that Snasky scored 420. That's a thing.
Snasky.
Look at that.
Snazzy.
The 420 MVP.
He even proves it in his own score.
Look at that stuff, man. The beautiful cars, the beautiful gameplay, taking it right back here to Rogue, who are going to have to figure out what they're going to change up. Big thing was, the story of the game, number one, they had the pace. They were outpacing it. They were controlling the ball in the Leftovers' territory. But game two, starting making defensive mistakes, and the Leftovers say, thank you, we will punish that, and they tie up the series easily.
It really was mostly on mistakes, and I think the Leftovers need to make sure they don't carry this victory into the next one, just saying, hey, we're just going to keep playing this, and it'll get us the wins. Mm-hmm. The first goal, you know, I think it was a good play by them, but also a little bit of a lapse in judgment on Rogue, and then from there, they just kind of seem to fall apart. So I hope that they understand they still need to work for this, because all Rogue needs to do is just kind of recollect themselves. Mm-hmm. Like, all right, second game, throw that in the dumpster. It's fine. It's done. Light it on fire. That loss never happened. We're not embarrassed, I promise. And then they're just going to move on from here. If they can fix those tiny mistakes, they're going to be just as strong as game one.
Mentally jettison the mistakes. Clean that out. Clean slate here as we move on to Urban Central for game number three. We will see who is able to take the lead in the series. The best of five, meaning this one will give somebody that two-win stat. We'll put them on match point. We're guaranteed at least a game four. At this point, we will see who is able to bounce back. First kickoff going mostly in favor of the Leftovers here. And it'll be Matt clearing it out of his corner. Snasky up towards Sicky. Still in the blue corner. Sicky will miss that one on the wall. That gives the space for Sizz to move that one down and transition onto offense for Rogue. He'll pass out to Matt. Open shot. Can he get it? No, it does not go in. It goes wide of the goal, and the Leftovers look to transition quickly.
They seem to have found the weakness. Now trying to get the counterattack as quickly as possible. Snasky just a mere inches away from putting that on target.
Turtle in the air. Carry that one away from the goal. Not allow Farrah to have a shot opportunity. Now Matt to Turtle. Passes back on towards the wall. Snasky will get it through Turtle. And Matt needs to rotate his Sizz up towards Turtle. The cherry pick. Does it go in? Oh! Didn't even need Turtle. Look at this shot from Sizz.
I wonder how much Sizz was screaming and telling Turtle not to touch it. There's no one back. Don't touch it. Don't touch it. With Turtle's camera view, he probably assumed someone could have been next to him and behind him. Didn't notice that Farrah was actually just cheating up a bit too much. Wasn't ready for a hard clear. And for the third game in a row, Rogue will take the lead.
They take the first goal. Three games now. The last game, it mattered not, because they dropped the game 5-3. Sagi's clear, puts this one high, but Matt over the top, winning the 50-50. Does it go in? Oh, can they get it? Oh, oh, there it finally goes from Matt. Snatsky had the save, but Matt finished it off finally.
We saw Matt with a nice Duncan League play, and here again, waiting for the defensive touch, trying to read it, and he goes up for it. He started the play, he finished the play. There's a reason Matt was runner-up for MVP.
And the setup from that, the initial shot from Matt, was a 150-50, still outpacing the leftovers here on offense. And as long as they keep those touches golden and clean and crisp, they will have a series win on their hands. Right now, having to play defense, Snatsky, win that 50-50. Matt there, early read. Sicky in the air, back into the middle. Matt with the save. The double commitment there will buy some space for Rogue to move, push out onto offense. There's Sicky around the corner. Back into the middle. Sizz in the back. We'll rotate with Turtle over the top. Be back down in the box. Sizz, excellent touch all the way to the orange corner. That requires leftovers to rotate all the way back, reset, and here comes that pressure from Rogue.
That kind of hard clear from Sizz is the perfect timing for that. One of his teammates had been demolished, and they were also struggling a bit on boost, so get the hard clear. Who cares if you give up possession? You want to buy your time as or buy your team as much time as possible.
Beautiful touch there from Matt. Not able to finish it off, but Snatsky now on the other end of the field, flying long and high to try and score. This ball just doing laps around the edge right now as both teams having kind of one-shot opportunities on offense before they transition. Matt again winning that 50-50 high on the ceiling. Turtle comes in to make the shot. Can he get the turn here? He's got a mind game, two defenders, but Snatsky, he'll tackle outright. Excellent play there by Snatsky, knowing he had Sicky behind him if he got mind gamed.
The patience was well timed, but the leftovers seemed to read it this time. They made sure to dedicate people to the right positions, and right now I'm enjoying their defense quite a bit. They always have somebody prepared for either to 50-50 or to save a net.
Good play there by Fair to get out of the double threat situation. Ball up at midfield, Sizz onto an open net. Can Sicky get there in time? The drag race between him and the ball, he does. The excellent save there from the veteran land player to put that one away. Keep this one at only a two-goal game. Leftovers, though, 2 minutes remaining here in Game 3, still looking for that first goal.
All these close, tight-knit saves from Leftovers, but they need to find a way to push it onto offense. They have 2 minutes left. That's a goal a minute. Will they be able to pull it off?
Sizz with Turtle immediately in support. He'll pass it off. Take the shot. Farrah gets the block. Excellent screenplay from Rogue, and it has them still with the offensive pressure. Sizz will take a shot. This one will go far post past the rookie, and that's a 3-0 lead for Rogue.
Now defensive mistake from Leftover. Snatsky didn't have the boost to follow up for that. I don't know if he knew he didn't, and Sizz took his time for that angle. As tight as it was, he was confident in the shot. He puts it far post. Couldn't get saved. That's now 3-0 for Rogue.
The chants coming out from the crowd, you know. The home field advantage is strong in U.S. Snatsky's shot towards the net. Sizz will play it away. Soft touch into the corner. 1:30 left to go. Farrah's miss by a lot of time for Rogue to space out on defense. Try and get the pressure going as they transition now into the corner. Sizz to Snatsky. It'll be Turtle who rotates in the midfield. They try to switch the rotation direction, but Rogue immediately resets it. This one will wrap around the corner. Snatsky again. Textbook clear, is able to get this one finally over the top of the Rogue defenders, or the Rogue offenders, rather. They'll transition. Nobody really set up very tightly there on defense, and no immediate punish from the Leftovers. With the final minute of gameplay, you still see no goals being scored from the Leftovers, even though they've had many opportunities here.
Now, any other team, I'd assume this would be defeating enough for them to maybe not feel good enough going into the next game.
Yep.
But if we know anything from the Leftovers, Matt, what are you doing to these poor guys? Able to get such a tight redirect from the corner. Sizz and Matt, this duo still almost unparalleled in either region. Phenomenal gameplay from these guys.
I mean, you talk about it. This is the Leftovers. This is the let's just reverse flip side Leftovers, right?
Yeah.
These are the guys that doesn't matter how far down they are to who they're down, they can bounce back. But still, goals like that, this late in the game, can just be morale breaking sometimes. The Leftovers have to dig down deep to find a way to bounce back. Because again, 4-0, this is what game one was like. We did not see Rogue giving them many defensive mistakes to punish here. And that was how they were able to win game number two. And as such, Rogue able to, okay. Just watch the way this drops down, and then Snatsky's like, thank you, I'll take that. Here comes
Silence.
Bop. He's like, thanks, appreciate it. Matt's like, come on, you really? Really? That's how that ends? What a play by Siki.
Bit of one of those happy accidents. Yeah. Yeah, it falls on top of you. You're not going to at least try and take advantage of it. Like, hey, why not? The goal might be enough to hopefully push them into a better spot. But, I mean, that was only their third shot this game to the seven that Rogue have already put up. Potentially one more if they can turn this back around. You know, and I think Leftovers do really well when the pressure's on and they have really no choice but to win. But will LAN prove just too much pressure?
Well, this is, we will find out right now, Carpet.
This is it.
They are now on match point. Rogue wins the next game. They move on in the series. If the Leftovers want to do what they always do, now is the time. They got to win two straight. We'll see if they can pull it off here. But Rogue lighting it up again here. Seven shots to three. This is Rogue, as we have seen them, the clear runner-up in North America.
I mean, this Rogue is completely on fire. I'm loving these guys. Mm. I can't get past that. I can't even find my own vocabulary. Not that it's that great anyways, but I'm loving watching this Rogue. They seem so confident. They seem so happy. You watch their walkout. I mean, these guys are just stoked to be here. And that's kind of what this is all about. That's what Rocket League has always portrayed. Just such a fun game, but still so complex at the core. And watching these guys execute so well, play as a team, even though there were so many mistakes in that second game, there's no animosity. No one's blaming each other for anything. Yeah. They came right back in game number three, and they're doing so well.
I don't have any brisk on me right now, or else I'd totally take the risk right now. You heard Snasky in his interview talking about how NRG from North America is the team he's most afraid of from North America, and because they are on such a different level than the rest of North American squads, but that does mean your runner-up here from Rogue is the team that is on top of what we would, you know, our normal North American Rocket League. Yeah. This is the best that what we usually consider to be NA Rocket League has to offer, as NRG's on this entirely different level. And right now, the Leftovers have their hands full. They got to do it two times in a row. But if any team can do it, it's the Leftovers. But right now, here on Manfield, storm's broken out. Rogue doesn't care. A win here moves them on in the bracket. It'll be Farrah down towards Siki. This is Leftovers with solid, immediate offensive pressure. This is exactly what they need to send us to the critical game five. It'll be our second game five of the day. Now Siki, only one in the back right now, but the ball punted very high. Gives lots of time for Rogue to rotate. Here's Farrah continuing. Another loft, turtle over to the side. Matt moves up immediately. No follow-up. That pinch goes dangerously close to the Leftovers net, but Farrah will be able to pick this one up on the side. Look it over, Turtle, towards the net. Sizz carries it away. A great play by Farrah. Shut down by Sizz.
Nice two-man defense. Turtle forcing the flick, and Sizz following through, albeit close. But
they find him on the rotation, and Farrah punishes. That's Leftover scoring first for the first time.
Now we see them trying to turn on the heat. Matt with a bit of a weak touch. Still very doable, but it doesn't matter. Leftovers take it right back off the back wall, and Farrah himself will put it into the far left side.
Just as we've said, it does not matter how badly they get beaten game to game. The Leftovers know how to bounce back. Siki, the veteran, he's been here so many times with so many different teammates, but Matt says, screw your backboard, I'm taking the shot directly.
And this right here is just showing how calm he is. Look at how wide he got for this shot. He swung all the way. He knew it would be a tight angle, and lining yourself up for those is pretty much 90% of the shot. He's just shot straight.
Right.
It's an easy shot at the core, but you need to know how to position yourself. So him positioning himself accordingly, well fought on him.
And that ties us up here in game number four. Match point favor going to Rogue right now. Matt to try and take a shot. Sizz with the follow-up here to bounce it back out to his teammate. Turtle rotates in quickly. Tight offensive three-man rotation from Rogue. But the defense of the Leftovers holds on. Snasky will try to pinch this one out, still keeping this tight two-man, 2-1 offensive positioning, and Turtle will get in the air. He'll finish it off. That's the Rogue team with the lead again.
At the moment, whenever Leftovers is stuck on defense long enough, they seem to eventually crumble. Snasky did come across, and that was well-timed, but the way Turtle positioned himself, it didn't leave Snasky any angles to actually push it out and away from him. They will now gain the lead after conceding the first goal. Rogue might take the series.
Oh, but Farrah has other stories. Again, that one just barely off the crossbar. Farrah's shots have been on point this series, just barely going wide of their target. The pressure definitely going to force Rogue to think about leaving more people on defense. That demo on Sizz opens up some space, but the clear game, Turtle's just going to put it back in. It's a 2v3 power play in favor of the Leftovers, and Turtle doesn't care.
Snasky dedicating for the demo, but then he got caught in net, wasn't able to turn around and help out. But either way, Farrah and Siki didn't position accordingly, and there's a counterattack. When you know you're a man down and you still dedicate to the play, you know you have to push it away from your net, and instead you just turn it into a shot on goal.
Well, and when you have a player demoed, usually it's what you get in the mindset of, we're on defense, so we got to play safe. But at the same time, if a hard clear is the perfect time, that's the perfect time to be more aggressive because you know you have a player who has to spawn in the back. So put your 2-1 up. Put your two players up in the offensive position. They do that, and the Leftovers were not ready for it. Up by two. Rogue set in a good position here. They hold on to this for the rest of this game. They will win the series. Out to Sizz, down to Turtle, taking another shot. Bounce board, Matt gonna be able to put that one in. Bounce board, I like that. 4-1 now for Rogue.
Just look at how close these touches were. Turtle over to Sizz, who drops it right back down to Turtle, who then clears it off the backboard. And just to make it clear, that touch from Sizz was all him. And the only reason I know is because that ball trail remained blue. Whoever touches it last makes it blue, so it looked like someone from Leftovers came across and helped with his touch, but that was all touch from Sizz, passing it right back to Turtle.
Can we call it a bounce board? I like that.
A bounce board? Is that what I said?
No, that's what I said.
Oh.
I called it a bounce board.
Yeah, why not?
I think it's fun.
We can do what we want.
That's right. We're 13. Snasky going to send that one back down to the corner. Sicky towards Farrah. Trying to wrap this one around. Down by three, but oh, it's just now halftime in game four. They have plenty of time to bounce back, but Turtle gonna put that one through. The crowd carries him through. You can see Sizz popping off on the stage. They are ready to play. They're up by four, Carpet.
At this point, Turtle just showcasing himself, waiting. Sicky didn't have a lot of choices there on defense. He didn't come from the net, so he had to try and read Turtle's touch, which was a little unorthodox, but the angle he took was actually unorthodox as well. Trying to touch it with its wheels. Four goals up, they must be feeling so strong right now.
And the crowd was chanting, "Let's go, Turtle," as he puts that in. The breakaway is going to, oh, Snasky gets the save. Keeps that one from extending 5-1. I'm not gonna mention a specific South American country just yet. We'll wait for one more goal to go in. But Fair wants to shut this one down right now. He'll put it in. There goes the Brazil. No chance of that. Still 2 minutes left. Only down by three. Leftovers are not out of this.
I mean, if there's any team I think can pull it off under pressure, even with a double dedication there. Oh, what?
Woo-hoo.
What was that? Fairy down to... Whoa,
double
down to
dedication?
Snasky?
No. Planned play. Calculated.
That was actually insane. I didn't notice that it touched off Snasky there at the very end. Even if it was yet another happy accident, phenomenal highlight reel play there.
Oh, Farrah. Can he do it? Matt to Sizz. That's not the touch he was expecting. Matt was not ready for that back pass. And Snasky will take it right away from him. Onto the backboard. Sicky in a position where he could potentially score. Set this one out for Farrah. But it'll be Matt out to Sizz. Farrah gets bumped hard. Matt into the midfield. Snasky and Sicky both up for this. The double commitment makes it confusing to block, but Rogue has it. Can Matt do it in the corner? The 1v2, he'll get this blown up. They're tired of his positioning. Sizz almost puts another one in, and Snasky now over the top. Leftovers is looking to push out.
Every second that ticks by is going to make this even more stressful for the Leftovers. Sizz will get the save. Right now, Rogue must be on cloud nine if they can keep this up.
Turtle over to the side. Sizz looking to try. Cannot make contact. Now Sicky in the air, way over the top. Air ball on both sides. Now Snasky up to Sicky in the cherry picker position. He's going to bounce off the corner. Back to Farrah. He looks for Snasky, the midfield. But Matt is away. Snasky keeps that ball in the blue. Turtle, not the best of positioning, but gets the clear. Just enough to buy his teammates time. Farrah has that one up high. Sizz clears it away. Close to an own goal, but he'll get that one away safely. Snasky back in the middle. 40 seconds remaining. Down by three. The Leftovers with so much work to do before this series is over. If they want to dream of game five right now. And Matt will just play that one over to the side. They're just going to play the keep away game. 30 seconds remaining. With every second it ticks by, it becomes less likely that the Leftovers could possibly come back in this one. Rogue has just been so much on point this whole series. Even that blazing shot from Sicky is blocked by Turtle.
Right now, it seems that the Leftovers are in that awful spot where they need to over-dedicate just to get a goal, but the moment they do, they're going to struggle just to get back in time for defense. They won't have a lot of counter clears, and will we see yet one more from Matt?
He'll put it in just before the end. It'll put the nail in the coffin. Rogue makes a statement here in round one, the 6-2 victory. They could potentially make it one more. We'll find out, but this will be the victory over Leftovers. We'll let the kickoff happen. The crowd's behind them. USA is here to play, folks.
So trying to shine a light in the shadow that is NRG on North America. They're trying their best to close that gap. They want to show that they're here to prove just as much as anybody else. A team that came out hyped, they ended hyped, ended in 6-2. Look at how happy these boys are. Oh, this feels so good for them.
Rogue coming out and making a statement. You know that has to feel good after rough beginnings to lands here for Turtle in the seasons 1 and 2. They come out against one of the favorite teams from Europe and are able to get a solid victory. Good camaraderie around on both sides of the pitch here. So you see the home crowd welcoming in the visitors.
You know, no matter what happens to Snasky, he always has just the greatest smile on his face.
He's always so happy.
I think that's what makes him so handsome, you know? Yeah, he's just so happy.
He's like Ryan Gosling and Arnold Schwarzenegger combined with, like, just a bunny or something.
Just
happiness.
That's for the happiness.
I love to see that. But Rogue, so much pace, so much speed.
Yep.
Game 2, they make some defensive mistakes, and then they clean it up in the next 2 games, and it was such solid play on all sides of the ball, cleanly getting the victory there over the Leftovers.
I mean, we talk about here at this stage in LAN, this is where you need to get, like, pretty much bring out the best in you, and Rogue seem to have just opened up right out of the gate. I know it's a little bit of what Turtle personally has struggled with, a little bit of stress, a little bit of anxiety, and as Gip said, his previous showings at LAN hadn't been so great, but he is here to just take a stomp on that, leave it in the past, and he wants to try and come out on top.
How would it feel to know the crowd is chanting your name as you score a show-off goal at the end of this series? It's incredible, but I want to hear from one of the players from Rogue, and I'm pretty sure the crowd wants to hear what Sizz has to say. Over to you, Awesome Joey.
All right, guys. We got Sizz here from Rogue. The home crowd is loving you. My goodness. All right, so everyone talks about the Matt Sizz duo. At the start, you guys were popping off together, making the plays you make and stuff. Talk about that duo and that between you guys.
First, I just want to say my team is nuts. Like, Matt and Turtle, I love my team. I love my team. It was a triple power. It was a power triple this game, not a power duo. Me, Matt, and Turtle, we have, like, the closest friendship you could have in a team. It's awesome.
That's excellent, man. Yeah, you could tell, especially a little bit later on in the series, you started seeing a lot of plays that were incorporating all three of you guys, and it was really crisp, man. So let's say now, you're feeling good right now.
Yeah, oh, I am feeling good.
Is there anything specific you'd like to talk about with your fans? Anything you'd like to say?
All day, baby!
All right, now, question everyone wants to know is, from you, how far are you guys going to go in this?
I think we have a pretty good chance to get into the winners' finals, honestly. We're doing pretty well in scrims and everything, so we're really confident. I think out of all the teams here, we definitely like the most relaxed on stage. Like, the comms, we were just like laughing the whole time we were playing. It was so nice, the way we play in the atmosphere and everything.
Sounds good, man. Well, keep it cool. You guys keep playing the way you're playing. Thank you so much. We're going to send it right back over to Axel Toss on the desk. Give it up for Sizz, guys.